Welcome to Stay at Home STEAM with Team Neutrino. Today we're going to be making paper rockets and learning about the science behind flight. For this activity, you're going to need paper, a straw, ruler, scissors, a pencil, and some tape. Now let's get started. First, you're going to want to measure out a piece of paper that's 4 centimeters by 24 centimeters. Next, using a pencil as a model, wrap your piece of paper around it. Now for the nose cone or the very tip of your rocket. Here's some options that you can try. First, you can fold over the paper and then tape it. Second, you can bunch up the tip and then tape it. Or you could cut the end into triangle-like prongs like a crown and then tape it into a point. Now for the fins. You can have as many fins as you want, and feel free to customize them to be as big or as little as you want. But here are some ways that you can go about making them. First, you can make a trapezoid and cut out tabs that will help you attach the paper to your rocket. Another way that you can make fins is by folding your paper into a rectangle and then cutting out fins that look like a triangle with a rectangle at the end. Once you cut it out, you can attach it to your rocket. Finally, once you're done making your paper rocket, you can place the paper rocket on top of a straw and then take it to an open area where you can blow in air into it and then see it fly across the room.
Now you're probably wondering how your paper rocket is flying. During flight, there are four different forces acting on your paper rocket. The first is thrust. This is a force that gets your rocket into motion. For example, when you blew into the straw, you gave it a thrust. The second is lift. This force is what is letting your rocket continue to fly through the air, and it's created by a difference in air pressure. Then there's a drag. This force acts opposite of the lift and is what makes your paper rocket slow down when it's moving through the air and eventually lose enough force to stay in motion. Finally, there's the weight. This is a force of gravity that pulls your paper rocket down to the earth.
Now that you have a final paper rocket, feel free to change the lengths or different type of fins to optimize your flight. Thanks for joining us on today's episode of Stay at Home STEAM with Team Neutrino. Don't forget to tag us on social media at FRC Neutrino and use the hashtag Stay at Home STEAM for a chance to be featured on our stories.